But what would you do if you saw someone, especially a child, in trouble? Would you jump in to help or assume that somebody else would do it? Recently, we went to the streets of suburban New York and put some folks to the test. Last time, security specialist Bill Stanton put two parents to the test to see if what they've taught their kids about the danger of strangers would serve them in a real-life situation. Today, he puts the public to the test. With the help of 7-year-old Raquel, Bill staged an abduction to see if the public would take action. Raquel's mom, Deborah, watched from a surveillance van as Raquel was approached by Bill.
Hey, where were you, young lady?
You're not my dad!
It's unbelievable, but they did nothing. Bill and Raquel repeated this time after time.
Hey,
please, someone help me! You're not my dad!
Please, someone help me!
You're not my dad! Please!
Still, no response.
Please!
It's frightening that nobody would help.
One woman walked right by, believing someone else would take action.
Never go away.
And why didn't she do anything?
You think that someone else will take the blame, someone else will take the responsibility.
A police sergeant on location to supervise was stunned.
I felt it was unbelievable that people just didn't want to get involved. They'd look, they'd turn around, they'd see with a commotion, but they just kept on walking. They didn't want to get involved, in my opinion.
Bill would have been long gone with 7-year-old Raquel. It took hours, but two men finally listened to their instincts.
TV. Cops right there. Cops right there. Good job.
She was saying, stop, someone help me. She's not my dad. He's not my dad. And I was like, first I thought she was being a little disobedient, but then you weren't saying nothing. So I was like, we got to stop this guy.
They parked the car and I just ran over to get him. Yeah, I was going to take him down, man. Yeah, it wasn't going to happen.
And I got to tell you, all you guys were good. You spread out.
Yeah,
I wasn't getting away. You guys weren't letting a bad guy go anywhere.
That was amazing. I actually had tears in my eyes, but everyone ran out, and I was like, oh, my God, I couldn't believe that they did what they did. And you would expect more people to react that way. I think just people are afraid to get involved.
Bill Stanton, good morning.
Good morning.
This is unbelievable. I mean, you watch this and you just think, what is the deal? How do you explain so much of that response?
It's tough stuff. I have goosebumps on my arms right now. It's called the bystander effect. This was a study done a couple of years ago where the more there are people watching something go down, the less likely someone's going to take action.
But here's the thing. A lot of, in some of the episodes there, even though you could hear little Raquel saying, this is not my dad, and that's the key point, at other times, it was just, don't you get away, don't you ever go away like that. So it could seem like there was just a child misbehaving and that you were the dad.
Yeah, but David, I'll put it to you this way, much rather be safe than sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Second guess yourself, but at least point it out, say something, call 911.
Right, but in other words, is a lot of that background noise for these people walking by, they think, oh, we've seen this 100 times, it's just a kid acting up?
No, I think part of it is we live in a fast food society. Everybody's in tune with what they have to do. They see something going down, go proactive.
Mm-hmm. Now, what about the people who are walking by? They think, okay, wait a minute. Am I going to take this guy on? He's a big guy. I got to be afraid of retaliation.
Well, different actions for different people. If you're a big strapping guy, as we saw, and I was proud of those guys, they took action. What you didn't see, there was an elderly lady in the background when those guys took action. She had her hand on the phone calling 911.
Mm-hmm.
Different actions for different people, but at least they're taking action.
And speed is important here, I would think.
Absolutely. Seconds count.
Mm-hmm. What should people keep in mind? You saw, again, I thought it was interesting that the two guys who ultimately charged you, their initial thought was, well, maybe this is just disobedience. But they kept listening. That's important, right? If your first instinct says, no, wait a minute, this is just a child. You just kind of keep paying attention.
You bring up a good point. You saw how they watched me. They were monitoring. Once they felt sure there wasn't even communication between the two of them, they took action. I was smiling, and then I got nervous.
Right, exactly. And you say they spread out. They kind of moved in on you, and it was pretty clear that you weren't going anywhere at that point.
Right. And you know about the new Amber program that they have.
Right. And let's talk about that a little bit, because this is a new technology that's developed by the West Virginia High Technology Consortium. This is really putting technology to good work. Tell me about it.
Absolutely. This is the latest technology. It's AmberView. Right now, it's only out of West Virginia. Mm-hmm. What they do, which is totally voluntary, during your child's school picture day, they take a photo. It goes into their database, and God forbid something should happen, that goes to all the local and national authorities and the media, putting a 3D photo of your child out there within seconds and minutes, hopefully helping recover your child.
And that 3D photo, we should point out, it was Elizabeth Smart, who was abducted in Utah, was actually identified through a profile shot. So it does matter, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Is there a chance that this is going to spread around to other states and go national?
Well, if people call in, yes, it will spread throughout the country, and it's only value-added.
Mm-hmm. Did this surprise you? Of all the scenarios you put together, did this surprise you the most?
Yeah, this one actually hurt and surprised us all, but it was heartening to see the young guys taking action.
The key there is for people to remember, everybody's got a different role to play. It's not about tackling you to the ground. Everybody can pay attention, and again, to listen, right, to every part of this scenario.
David, the most important thing here is to step up, not step out of the picture.
Okay, Bill Stanton, thank you.